Hello students, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we'll be studying about programming language types. Now, in the previous videos, we have studied the topic of software and we studied about system softwares in the last video. So now, as we can recall, softwares are of three main types. The system software that we studied in the last video, the second is the programming tools, and the last one is the application software. So in this video, we'll be studying in detail about the programming tools. Now, what do we mean by programming tools? Programming tools are any softwares that help in programming. These can help in any of the two ways. Either they can help in writing of a program, and these include the softwares that allow you to code in different platforms, okay, which are generally known as integrated development environments. Or the other kind of programming tools can be translators. Once you have written any program or any kind of code, they need to be converted from that language in which you have coded into a language that can be understood by the computer. Okay, so there are different computer languages in which generally the program is written, different high level languages. Why do we say it as a high level language? These are the languages that are understood by the humans very easily because they are generally in the form of English-like phrases. Okay, now they are high level because they cannot be understood by the computer. You must convert high level languages into machine level languages, or what you say as machine code, so that the computer can understand it. Okay, so all these kinds of tools which either help us in programming or converting a programming code into a form that are understandable by the computer are referred to as the programming tools. Okay, now we'll be studying what are the different types of programming languages in this video. Okay, so as I told you that there are programming languages that are easily understood by the humans, and these include languages like Java, C, C++, Python, Ruby, and so on. But these languages cannot be understood by the computer. Computer only understands binary numbers, binary digits, which are zeros and ones. Okay, we have studied this previously also. So the languages which are understood by humans are known as high level languages, and the language or the code that is understood by the computer is known as low level language. Okay, now fine graining the concept of low level language, that means going in more detail, low level languages are again of two types. Low level language can either be assembly level language or assembly language, and the other is the machine code. So machine code or machine language is in the form of zeros and ones. This is the language that is ultimately required by the computer system. This is the language that is understood by the computer system. Even assembly language is not directly understood by the computer system. Okay, so why is it called low level language? Because it is compared to high level languages, it is closer to the machine code. And why is it closer to the machine code? Because in this assembly language also, the instructions are written in the form of operation codes and addresses, so operation codes are basically also known as opcodes, as mentioned in your book also. And these operation codes can be in the form of any operation that you want to perform with the data, or any instruction that you need to give to the computer. Like if you have to push some data, or you have to put some data into some memory register, then you use the command push, or any keywords like this in the assembly language. Assembly languages they include some addresses, they include some operation codes, but they are not directly understood by the computer system. Okay, so why were assembly languages built in itself? Assembly languages were built because So I'll be starting with the machine languages. What is the problem with machine language? Machine language consists of 0 and 1. So it is very difficult for any human to write all the code in the form of zeros and ones. Okay. It is very difficult to remember so many combinations. It is very difficult to remember the memory addresses and what is the configuration. And this might vary from system to system. So to ease this much effort, to reduce this effort, there came assembly languages. Assembly languages now started initially. Assembly languages consisted of, or they still consist of, some English-like operation, English-like words which specify what operation to be performed, and some addresses. Okay, this also included some addresses. So it was not very, very easy. Plus, another limitation of assembly language was there was a restriction on the type of opcodes that were required by every architecture. Different types of CPUs needed to be coded differently. They need to have a different assembly language, and there was no portability among the machines. That means a code that is written for a specific type of CPU, assembly code that is written for a specific kind of CPU, may not work for any other kind of CPU. Okay, so although assembly language was better than machine language, because not everything was in the forms of zeros and ones, there were English like keywords, but it had the portability issue. Okay, and that is why we call it machine dependent. It depended on the architecture of the CPU that was being used. Okay, so there came the concept of high level languages. High level languages do not contain any addresses, do not contain any hard codings. Okay, high level languages are almost written in a way that comprise of English like words, right? And they are easily understood by humans, and they are independent on the type of machine they are running. Okay, so this is the basic difference between all three languages. But since I have told you that either there is high level languages or they are assembly languages, they need to be converted, both of them need to be converted to machine language, that is in the form of zeros and ones, for the computer to understand them. Okay, that is why we have softwares like assemblers. Assemblers convert assembly language to machine language, and there are compilers and interpreters that convert high level language to machine language or machine code. Okay, so in this, the main points that we have learned in this lecture, these are very important that you must note down or jot down if you have to take notes. So we were discussing programming tools, specifically programming languages. Now there are two main categorization of programming language: the low level language and the high level language. The high level language consists of English like words. They are not understandable by computers directly, but they are easy to write for humans, and they are machine independent. So the examples of high level languages include any coding language, Python, C++, Java, and so on. Okay, low level languages, on the other hand, can be further categorized into two categories: machine language and assembly language. Assembly language, although it has English like words, but it still contains some use of addresses, and it is machine dependent. That is the drawback of this. And machine language is in the form of binary digits. It can be directly understood by the computer, but it is very difficult to write. So this was the gist of this the lecture containing programming languages. In the next lecture, we'll be studying about assemblers, compilers, and interpreters. So stay tuned to this lecture series. In case you have any doubt, do not forget to mention them in the comment section below, and stay tuned to our channel for more videos. Subscribe to this channel, press the bell icon if you understood the video, and hit the press the like button if you understood the video, and hit the bell icon if you want to get further notifications of our future videos. So see you in the next video. Till then, mind your exam.